10 je ovaj, da li gore?
Da,
tu su u strnu.
Grupa 7.
Ok, prvo imam naravno zadovoljstvo. Najkrasnije, naravno. Da prvo naravno pozdravi.
To say hello again to you.
I da upoželjem dobrodošlicu na košarkaški kamp. Kasta.
One more time to say you welcome to Camp Kasta.
Međunarodnom košarkaškom sudi.
One friend on international FIBA referee.
Milivoju Jovčiću.
Mr. Milivoju Jovčiću.
I da naravno upoželjem da se dobro osjeća ovdje kod nas.
And also I wish him to feel very well.
I da naravno uradi ovaj posao za koje je došao. Da vam prenesem njegovo ogromno iskustvo, kako pitanje.
And to share his biggest experience with us.
Kako pitanje, ono je naravno pravila košarkaške igre.
About the rules in basketball game.
A pogotovo sa aspekta njegovog iskustva pragmatičnog.
From his angle and his experience.
A ne sa aspekta teorije pravila košarkaške igre.
And not only about the theory of the rules in basketball game.
Samo uvijek malo posljednu rečenicu, ali je produženo, onda ćemo. Po njemu je stvarno mogao jasno čovjek, puno toga satima ne govorim, ali u nekoliko rečenica ću vam reći moje impresije kao Peter Jovčić, i ne samo Jovčić, još jedan sjajan sudija iz njegove generacije, to je mali ovaj, Ilija Belošević. Po meni, iz perspektive, vi stari treneri, zato znate, sudi iz bivše Jugoslavije, stari Jugoslavije, i naravno kasnije ove SRJ, a SCG, a sad Srbije. Stari Jugoslavija imala puno dobri sudija. A kad se malo vratimo na SRJ i SCG i Srbiju, ima također Srbija puno dobri sudija. Ali po meni, jednom dvojica najbolji sudija u istoriji, inače, ovaj košarkaški sudija sa naših prostora su Česlija i dvojica, Belošević i Milivoj Jovčić. Naravno, moje, kako se kaže, moja impresija i koje iskustvo, ali po moje iskustvo ogromno i kad ja to kažem, da to sigurno tako. I zato mi je posebno drago da je Milivoj tu, da govorimo o najboljih sudija. Naravno sam najveći međunarodnu karijeru. Prevedimo ovo mi moment, ovo što vam rekao.
Profesor,
da.
One of the best coaches from ex-Yugoslavia is Milivoj Jovčić and one younger referee named Ilija Belošević.
The referee is not coaches. The referee is not coaches.
Professor's opinion is that those two guys are the best referees in this part of
the world. So, najveći udar, vi čakaško mu ne karijer.
They have a
uspešno
profession.
To kažem, uvijek imam naravno s ovaj činjenica, pošto ja dugo bio vani da dođe u velikim košarkaškim problemima.
When I say so, I have facts of
the... Što kroz delovaj, kroz klubske probleme, što kroz reprezentaciju.
Clubs programs, through national teams program.
Na svim velikim međunarodnim takmičenjima.
On all international tournaments.
Klubski Evrope, znači Euroliga, Eurocup.
And Euroliga.
Eurocup, Europe champion,
World championships,
Olympic Games. To su uvek bili njih dvojica u završnom pričanju.
Those two guys were until the end and in the finals.
To je njihov sigma. Prema tome, znači nije bilo njegov slavno imenijanje, nego to skrivnice.
I'm saying this, I'm not emotional. Guys, I'm telling you about
the CD,
and these are facts.
And
it's not
only that you got to catch up with eliminations, but the catch up with the results.
They were in the finals, in the same final games of Olympic Games, European Championships, not only in eliminations,
but also in the Olympics.
I'm talking about the
quality. Zbog toga želim da vas pažno pozdravite i da vam pozdravite. možete, ako želiš...
Ne, ne, bolje je to...
Možete ponoviš priču, da su problem, da ovdje odavde se obraća. Da možete da...
Dobro, ja mogu, nije meni problem. Ne,
ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne,
ne, ne,
ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, ne, aha, da li ovako mora biti kupa, mora i ovako, da? Ok, ajde.
Zastav, zastav.
Jer normalno da ima naša ovaj komunikaciju sa njima direktno, ne ovako je iza leđa. Bar po meni, da li već sad. Ok, Milo, izvoli.
The subject of today's class is the relationship between coaches and the referees. Zvijete što se vam malo odličeno, mi podnosimo malo više poštovanje. Between the referees and the coaches. Of course, I will speak my impressions and I will tell you my experience till now. But whenever during the lesson, if you have any doubt, if you have any question, feel free to raise your hands and ask me whatever you want. Today, like I told you, I'm having a subject relationship between referees and coaches, but you can ask me also concerning the rules and concerning the things about the history of the basketball rules and about the certain articles in the rules. Okay? First of all, when we are speaking about relationship between the referees and the coaches, I like to say that all of us, it doesn't matter if we are referees, coaches, managers, journalists, or whatever, we are coming from the court. From the court under brackets, because all of us, probably, we are having a basketball past. Basketball past which began on the court. Some of us were great players, some of us were medium players, some of us finished our careers in the cadets or the juniors, youth competitions, but all of us, we continue with basketball after we stop our career on the court. And depends on the personality, depends on the habits, depends on the circumstances, we continue some way. I continue as a referee. First of all, I had a plan to become coach, but because my parents were teachers and I know how big job and how hard is this job, I continued as a referee and taking care about myself. My opinion is that your job as a coach is the most difficult job in the basketball world, because you are working with people, and you are having the topic and the role of the creators of the basketball player. So everything is depends on you. In the past, like I told you, the usual thing was that when somebody finished his player's career, he continued either as a coach, either as a referee. And during, let's say, my time, the time of professor, our friends Krle, it was like this. Today's players, when they are finished their careers, they usually continue as coaches or as managers. And the point as a manager is now is more and more important in today's basketball. But we will stay in today's topic, I said, relation between coaches and the referees. First of all, my attitude is that we are all working the same job. And we are all necessary in order to create the game in a normal way. You are creators, you are making tactic. You are forcing your players and you are leading your players. You are taking care about team and we are taking care about the king. Many people does not know to make difference between team managing and the game managing. Coaches are responsible to manage with the team. Referees are responsible to manage with the game. And this is my opinion. If we think like this, then we can continue. Then we are coming to the court, which is the final stage of our cooperation. First of all, I think that the relation between the referees on one side and the coaches on the other side has to be with full respect. With full respect, and coaches, as the creators, has to understand that a referee is ready to listen. But this speech cannot be speech of the 5 or 10 minutes. This speech has to be maximum 1 sentence. So you can give your opinion in a normal way, in a polite way, and you can also expect that the referee will answer you in the same way. Many times, all of us, it doesn't matter if we are referees or coaches, are having the wrong impression. 1,000 times I saw my games where I blow the whistle or do not blow the whistle, and it was a mistake. But in that moment, I thought that it was the right thing for the game. So, the skills and the readiness to be in the role of somebody else is your advantage if you can do it. Put yourself sometimes in the position of the referee on the court. I deeply believe that all of you during the practicing or practicing games, you take a whistle and you call the game. And then you can understand how difficult it is to referee the game. So, understanding of the position and understanding of the difference between roles of the coaches on the one side and the referees on the other side is the essential thing that you understand generally philosophy of the basketball player. I completely understand that during the game your target is to win the game. This is normal, this is human, all of us, we are competitive. But on the other side, you have to understand that the target of the referees is to have a regularity in the game, throughout all the game, from the first till last second. Like I told you, I respect that you are creator of the game, and your freedom is a biggest freedom what somebody has to have on the basketball court. Because you are having ideas. And through the player, you are realizing that ideas on the court. We referees, we do not have ideas like you. It's not allowed for us to have ideas because we are service providers. We are having certain standards, certain limits, and we have to keep the game in a certain framework within the limits. And from that point of view, you have to be aware that you are leading the game from the creation point. Referees are only service providers. Like I said, it's very helpful, especially before the season, to have some kind of clinics, some kind of seminars, where you coaches are giving your opinion cases on the game. And when you exchange your opinion with the people who are responsible for the rules, then we are coming to the final decision, to the decision with what we call standard for the next season. In the EuroLeague, usually they have a meeting of the coaches, I mean head coaches, and they are watching different cases from the different games. They are giving their opinion, and finally they are having a conclusion. This conclusion will be presented to the referees after this meeting with the coaches and before the season. So we all know, will we use advantage-disadvantage principle, will, what is the unsportsmanlike foul, when it's a technical foul, when it's a disqualifying foul, what is flopping, what is not flopping, etc., etc. So like everywhere, the point is that we understand that we are just a part of the system. And system is contained of the coaches, referees, managers, and all the other people who are helping to the basketball game. Because basketball game is the final product. People are coming to see the players, how they play. You know that very well. Till yesterday, most of you were players. So the game and the basketball gym for us is like a church. Everything must be perfect and within the framework of the rules and of the standards. This is my general attitude, and in a relation with different people, in a different places, I'm trying to implement philosophy either of FIBA, either of EuroLeague. But generally, philosophy is the same. So this is my monologue. Now it's your turn to ask what would you like to ask. Nadam se da sam bio i vama jasan, bez obzira što sam. Engleski nije perfektan, ali dovoljno da se razumije.
On je bio super sve. Now, questions? No? Izvolite, pitanje.
This is the reason why this is traveling violation. most of the players do not think about this. And it's very often, and it's very usual. Unfortunately, also most of the referees do not have ability to understand that this is the travelers.
Thank you.
Generally, it doesn't matter if you're serving your money, if you're